Okay, we're back here. Day two of Strata. This is SiliconANGLE's exclusive coverage of Strata Conference. O'Reilly Media is an awesome conference around big data. It's the epicenter of innovation, business value. This is theCUBE, our flagship program. We've got the events, extract the ceiling from the noise. And this is the end of day two, wall-to-wall coverage. It's almost 6 o'clock here, and just an amazing packed event. I'm here with my co-host Dave Vellante. Dave, let's do the wrap up real quick, because I know we have some meetings to go to and get some more content and get some more stories to bring you tomorrow on day three, another full day. So quick wrap up. The big story here today is Tim O'Reilly came on. And I think Tim O'Reilly really brought his mojo and his game today, because you know he was fired up and talking about the business value, but again, hitting all his marks, right? Tim sees the vision and he understands what's happening around big data. And he pointed out that doing things more around society and healthcare continues to be the push, and the evolution away from speeds and feeds to much more value-driven approach.
Yeah, and he's talked about how basically data
is going to, where there's value, it's going to be siloed for a while. There's going to be a democratization movement, but it's not going to have an impact until the next big thing comes along, kind of, using the software analogy. So that was quite interesting.
Ed Dunbill on and Alistair Kroll, the co-chairs. They were outlining that the user experience as key, operational and analytics is going to be key. Dave, what is your thoughts on what's happening here today, day two?
Well, the other thing that was funny, I think it was Ed Dunbill was saying, everybody's talking about the Duke platform wars, the distro wars, and of course, we've talked about that a lot, John, and we do that, and his point was, well, it doesn't really matter, it's all about the business value. While that's true, I will point out that the reason for these wars is because people see the opportunity. It's a big market, we've quantified it at 11 plus billion, growing to 50 billion. People know that if they can win that platform war, they can build an entire ecosystem around it and make billions in terms of market cap. Will there be another Red Hat of Hadoop? Pat Gelsinger said no, there won't. And essentially my interpretation of that is because we're not going to let Red Hat of Hadoop run away with it. So that's why there's so much focus on these platform wars. And over time, it's not going to matter other than the fact that somebody's going to win it, and the first guy in is going to make a ton of money, the second guy in is going to make a little money, and nobody else is going to make any money. So that's why it's so interesting, and from a competitive standpoint, we love that. But I think I do agree with Ed, at the end of the day, it's all about what kind of business value can you drive, because practitioners are going to create more value than the suppliers. I think that ultimately his premise will prove true.
I think Mark Madsen, analyst on here, who's very prolific, he's very humble guy, but he's really plugged into the whole evolution. And this notion of data processing, Dave, has come back mainstream. And I think Mark really nails it when he says that it kind of depends on your worldview, how you want to evaluate the moves by the big vendors. But he said something really important, and that is none of the big vendors really define the platform. And the architectures really don't come from the vendors. They bring solutions to the marketplace, and that the architectures need to be developed by the marketplace. And I think what we're seeing out there is what Cloudera and Hortonworks are doing, are laying down a platform.
I think the other thing that has been bubbling through this event, much more so than any other Strata or the other big data events that we track, is security. We saw Intel's move with its own distribution, really playing its hand in security very strongly, I might add. We've got tomorrow more discussion on security. Squirrels coming on, the guys who are trying to commercialize the Cumulo project. And I think that this whole Internet of Things, John, to me, I've said a number of times, security is a do-over. I think the whole Internet of Things, the whole Stuxnet virus, example, opening Pandora's box, I think there's a whole new security model that is going to come out. And so there's the one end, big data needing to be more secure, and the other is using big data for predictive analytics in terms of potential threats and predicting potential threats. So security, I think, is a big theme that we're going to hear more and more and more about. I tried to get Joe Turian to even talk about it. He said, look, it's too big of a topic. I don't even want to go there. We don't have enough time. So I think that that's a big problem that needs to be addressed, and we're going to hear more and more about that. I think I would expect we're going to hear more about it at this event and others down the road.
Well, I think the big news here, obviously, is Strata is an emerging marketplace, and the big data world is growing like crazy, and this growth is not going to stop. The enterprise is going to come in the front door. John Stogdill, who runs the whole Strata event here for O'Reilly, said it best. Big data is coming in the front door and it's coming in fast, and it's not going to be like Linux, how it's kind of snuck around and groped in, it kind of snuck into the enterprise. Big data is coming in the front door, it's going to come in fast, and everyone's adopting and seeing Intel, EMC, and the big players coming in with a big way is going to force an execution, and we will be reporting on it. So it's going to move from operational data warehouse and business intelligence to transformative new architectures around data platforms. So we'll be here back tomorrow, day three for our live coverage, blanket coverage from siliconangle.com and wikibon.org. This is theCUBE. We'll see you tomorrow and have a good night.